From morphine, a naturally occurring substance found in the seed pod of certain varieties of poppy plants. It is a very addictive opiate.
An opiate is a powerful illegal drug that is made from a type of poppy.
Heroin use increased significantly in the U.S. with 669,000 users in 2012 compared to 620,000 in 2011 and 373,000 users reported in 2007.
That is about a 179% increase over 5 years.
We interviewed Chris Gleason, who is the director of Rosecrans, a rehabilitation center in McHenry County.
Have you seen an increase in heroin addiction since 2002?
There's been a significant jump in McHenry County related to heroin since 2002. And that would be related to factors of accessibility, transportation, ease of getting the drug. It's very cheap. $10 a bag, $20 delivered to your door. The railway system is easy to accessible. I also think our instant gratification for like even social media or phones or all that also has helped promote that more because people can get things faster and connect faster than they did before.
Heroin users do not usually fit the drug junkie stereotype.
A junkie is thought to be thin with dark circles under their eyes, does not care about personal hygiene, and does not do well in schools or the workplace.
Heroin addicts are probably one of the brightest group of people I've ever worked with. So my example would be the group I used to run, all of them were in the top 3 or top 5% of their high school class or college class and graduating. So addiction does not distinguish if you're smart or not smart. If you have money or don't have money, addiction is an equal opportunity disease, and heroin is the most equal opportunity because most people think it's really not going to hurt me. So even if people are bright with addiction, you don't make bright decisions.
It is very difficult to spot a heroin user by appearance.
You can never tell who's an addict and who's not an addict or who used to be an addict. For instance, I've been in recovery for 26 years, and most people wouldn't even think that if they saw me outside of this environment. So addiction is equal opportunity. That's, if you carry anything away, that's the piece. Thank you.
Short-term effects of heroin include cloudy memory and slow breathing, possibly to the point of respiratory failure.
Long-term effects include infection of heart lining and valves, kidney disease, liver disease, skin infections, and death.
Heroin users develop an addiction which causes them to be dependent on the drug.
Brian Wolf, a former McHenry High School student, talks about heroin.
A sick, sick drug that ruins people's lives, sucks the life out of you, ruins everything. Seventh grade, smoking weed, and started drinking alcohol when I was about 15. And that led to hallucinogenic drugs when I was a sophomore in high school, and then a little bit of cocaine use. From there, when I was a junior, is when I started getting into hard drugs, such as experimenting with crack and heroin, and that's how it started.
Ms. Wolf talks about her son's dependency on the drug.
Using heroin, and he was fighting it, he always fought it, but he couldn't overcome it. We would talk when he was lucid. We would have discussions, and I would ask him about it, and he would tell me. My son wanted to stop. He didn't want to be an addict. He wanted to stop. He didn't like it. And in the end, he said it was just using it just to feel good, because you, when you're coming down, you feel so bad, you can't, it just hurts. So that's my, I mean, that's my take on it.
In the arms of an angel.
What would you say to Brian if he was still around today?
Wow. Well, I'd hope that he wouldn't be using anymore. And I'd tell him I love him. I'd tell him what I told him the night before he died, which was, there's nothing you can do or say that would make me love you any less. I love you with all my heart.
All I could do is be there for him and support him and tell him how I felt about it. He loved me, loved eating meat, and I'm a vegetarian, and I've been a vegetarian since I was 8, so it's been like my whole life, and that's always been like something he jokes about with me, and he'd always try to get me to eat meat. And one thing he even said, he was like, I'll go to a vegetarian restaurant with you, like I want to hang out with you and everything. So I think we would have been really close. I think we would have had a really good relationship and been really open with each other.
Heroin affects families of users in different ways.
There was a lot of discord between my husband and myself. Since Brian's death, our family has fallen apart. My husband left. We lost our house. The sadness that'll never go away.
As addicts eventually run out of money, a life of crime becomes a viable alternative, costing society millions of dollars in legal fees and social welfare programs.
He stole a lot from me, a lot of money, a lot of money. I could never figure out where my money was going and how I was spending it.
Families of heroin users can suffer from anger, sadness, confusion, regret, and despair. Children of drug abusers are often abused or neglected because of their parents' preoccupation with the drug.
One may think that heroin is a problem that can just be ignored, but in reality, it is right in our own backyard. There were 52 heroin deaths in McHenry County from 2009 to 2012.
From July 2012 to June 2013, more patients were admitted for heroin use than any other drug, including alcohol.
The McHenry County Sheriff's Office said its cases jumped from 30 in 2012 to 95 in 2013.
There's a significant increase. Our county probably has a little bit more related to median income and accessibility and all those things I talked about earlier. The railway system, it's not that far from Chicago, so we'd probably be in the top 10 in the state. The country, where, you know, Chicago was one of the number one heroin locations in the country, so we're hanging in there with that. So it's not a good designation.
While the police play a huge role in combating heroin, McHenry County needs to come up with new ways to fight the heroin epidemic.
Every police and fire responder should have Narcan, a drug that reverses the effects of an opiate overdose.
McHenry County needs to identify and provide services to youth and adults who are at risk for heroin use.
What would you say to heroin users or people on the path to using heroin?
Talk to them with compassion and realize that they're people. And they have families, and many of them were high functioning before they got addicted to the drug, and encourage them to seek help.
Even if you don't physically die, you're gonna be a different person. Keep trying, don't give up, because that's the hard thing, is they just keep trying to get better and failing, and after a while they lose faith, they lose hope, they think they can't do it, so just keep trying. Think of everyone in your life who, you know, wants you to get better. Think of yourself.
You have to really want to get better. You have to want to, overcome it.
Do not let anyone else suffer from this horrid drug. Help McHenry County become heroin free.
She's talking to angels, counting the stars, making a wish on a passing car. She's dancing. Waiting for Superman to
Nothing's making sense. She's been chasing and